City Hall may be empty, but our local government is working. The City Council just made history. After their first ever remote meeting, now members are working around the clock, pushing through new legislation. Everything from getting hazard pay for essential workers to making sure COVID-19 survivors can stay in their homes.
Ever since the pandemic, we're working 24/7 nonstop.
After responding to the city's COVID-19 crisis for weeks, now members of the City Council are back together thanks to technology, diving into legislation to chart the city's rebound.
What was it like yesterday having your first virtual council meeting?
It was a little unreal. I never thought we'd actually be doing it.
From every corner of the city, they logged into Zoom. Attendance was perfect. Then it was time to work.
What you're fighting for?
An essential workers bill of rights that I'm hoping we can get passed in the next 2 weeks in time to have a real impact during this pandemic.
If passed, the Bill of Rights for essential workers would include paid sick leave for independent contractors. Businesses with more than 100 essential employees would have to provide hazard pay, ranging from $30 to $75 per shift.
We have legislation that would put protections in place for those essential workers so that they speak out and say, I need protective equipment. They can't get fired for that.
There's also a bill under consideration to open up 75 miles of city streets across the five boroughs so pedestrians and cyclists can maintain social distance. This afternoon, there was a virtual committee hearing to discuss creating more social distancing opportunities inside homeless shelters. And Bronx Councilman Richie Torres is pushing to protect tenants.
Under the bill, a landlord would no longer have the ability to harass you because you have COVID-19. Or because you're a frontline worker at risk of contracting COVID-19, or because you've lost the ability to pay rent because of unemployment caused by COVID-19.
And do you expect a lot of opposition?
I expect opposition from landlords who are looking to exploit the crisis and take advantage of tenants.
Councilman Torres has firsthand experience with COVID-19. He tested positive for the virus a few weeks ago. Torres tells us he was able to avoid hospitalization, and tonight he is recovered. Reporting from City Hall, Ayanna Harry, Pix 11 News.